folks.
Good morning, fellow Toastmasters. That wasn't loud enough. Good morning, fellow Toastmasters. I hereby call this meeting of Lake Mary Toastmasters Club 6400 to order. Before we begin, please silence those cell phones. I would like to ask for everyone to please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by a moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please be seated. As many of you know, our club mission is to provide a supportive learning environment through which members feel empowered to become better public speakers by developing their competent communication and leadership skills. And without further ado, please help me welcome today's Toastmaster, Ms. Lori Richards.
Today's meeting theme is When I Grow Up. And I know that, when I was little, I wanted to be a teacher when I grew up. And I'm sure many of you had other dreams of being a professional baseball player, football player, MMA fighter, actress, model, whatever. And I thought today just would be a nice reminder encouragement for us to think back about when we were kids and the joy that we got just imagining what we would be like when we got older, and just kind of remember that, because we're busy and we have people that we have to care for, we have all these pressures from work, and sometimes it's just nice to stop and be joyful and carefree and live. And let's meet our technical table for the day. I am going to introduce our grammarian, Crystal Strickland. Woo!
As a grammarian, it is my function to select the word of the day to help build members' vocabularies. Each member, when called to speak, is encouraged to use the word of the day. See, I have it here. Other members may gently rap on the table when they hear the member use the word. So today I chose the word blithe, which means happy, without worry. And I used it in this sentence here. It is a rare treat to see adults blithely playing charades. Which I actually did witness recently. In addition, I will be listening for errors in grammar, as well as excellent word selections. I will also be noting any colorful thoughts or phrases members may use. During the evaluation portion of the meeting, I will present my report. All right.
And our awe counter for the day is Carmen Lopez.
As awe counter, it is my function to listen for the use of filler words such as ah, you know, so, okay, and other audible pauses as fillers. I will be noting if members perform any double clutches, which means to say things twice, such as this means. Finally, I will also include things which might be distracting, such as lip smacks. I will present my report at the end during the evaluation portion of the meeting. My function is to time the speakers, evaluators, and tabletopic participants to ensure they meet the timing requirements. I will demonstrate the timing lights, Very good. Okay. And the green, of course, as you know, is the on time, the yellow is 1 minute more, and the red is the final minute. I understand someone told me that we don't have any disqualified participants here in this club. So, at the end, I will report the timer's results. Woo!
That's right.
It is a great honor that I would like to introduce someone who's giving her icebreaker speech today. So if you will help me welcome to the front, Ms. Nini Quintero.
I was born in Colombia in 1988, and I had the best life any nuclear family would have. When I was 13, my dad was killed, so my life changed completely. I was a refugee. I came to this country with asylum, and that's where my second life started. I had to grow up. I was the oldest of four, and then my mom, always a homemaker, it was a little difficult, so we started from zero. After having such an amazing life. I studied, I tried to continue, and I graduated. After that, a lot of things happened to a point that my highest weight was 198 pounds. Yes, I was depressed. I even took depression medication, which was something very, very, I never thought I would ever do that. I just grew up too fast. A year ago, I decided to change my life, so that's where my third life started. I took control of my life. I started exercising, eating right, saying yes to life. And I did it on myself. I did it quietly. I didn't post anything. But then I started noticing people were actually tapping my back. People were reaching out to me. And someone even told me once, "You're a diamond in the works." And I was like, wow, it was amazing. It was amazing to hear that I'm changing people's lives without noticing, just by trying to be happy. I started looking for happiness. I started looking for myself. And I knew that I had it all this time. All this time. I just needed to craft it and make it together. I started meditating. I started just, you know, being friendly, smiling. I didn't have lines here already. I spent so much of my life. I found happiness, and now I'm a sponge to knowledge. I love people, and people are asking me to help them. I'm actually coaching people, and I do not expect that we'll ever do that. The most amazing thing is that almost 3 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago, someone offered me I wanted to be a coach, and that person is offering to help me into becoming a speaker because they see that I have to share my story. They're like, you can't be selfish. So that's why I'm trying to share who I am. And I am changing people's lives while being myself, and I will not change this woman for anything. What makes you happy?
Thank you.
I'm just going to introduce the next speaker. Have you ever had a sleepless night where you toss and turn all night and just can't go to sleep? What wild or weird thoughts run through your mind on these restless nights? Here to share with you what was on her mind is distinguished Toastmaster Julia Kaufman.
Academy of Leadership. And in this leadership course, we talked about
Communication, effective communication skills. Making sure that you're clear, you're specific. Articulate your message, but more importantly, is your message understood? So a few months later, I get an email from him, and in the subject line it said, word. Just word, no body, nothing in the body. And in that one word, I knew exactly what he meant. He meant to make me laugh and to say, we're ramping up, it's time to start our project together. So I responded in all my professionalism, what up? There's another phrase we use at work. I don't know if you've ever heard this used. I hear it a lot in meetings where there's brainstorming or distinction, difference of opinion. And somebody will say, let me throw that out there. Let me just throw this out there. Let me just throw it out there. And I always think to myself, God, I hope somebody catches it. What about this one? Is everybody on the same page? Everybody on the same page? Everybody on the table of contents? Yep, I'm there. I'm sitting on top of Roman numeral one. Great. Danny, get your ass out of the conference and get back here. Bill, get your head out of the conclusion and get back here. Sue, stop reading ahead and get back here. Sorry, I got loose. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is what's going through my head. I look at my clock, it's 3:00 in the morning. And I'm like, oh my gosh, God, please get me off this idiom roller coaster. And then all of a sudden, I drifted off to sleep. And ladies and gentlemen, that's a wrap.
To add to Julia's cool beans. I'm an underwriter, right? And I was out in California training. And we couldn't do this loan for this guy because his position was chief ganja officer. And it was true. They were trying to get this loan through, and there were all these discussions, and we couldn't do it because it's legally kept in Colorado, but not anywhere else. Or as a federal government, we couldn't, you know, allow these loans to go through. So anyway, chief ganja officer, if that's what you do, and you're trying to get a loan, you need to not say that that's what you do. Speaking from the Entertaining Speakers Manual, Make Them Laugh, with his speech, Sticks and Stones, our next speaker is going to talk about, in a random kind of way, why it's so very important for parents, especially in this supercharged political environment, to tell their kids that they suck. Yes, to tell their kids that they are good for nothing and that they are the worst things to happen to mom and dad since Rush Hour 3.
I know what you're all thinking. Martin, you look especially sporty today. Patriotic. You know what? You'd be right. But that's not all. I'm dressed in uniform.
Really?
And in homage to my buddy, Rich Massa. Allow me to address myself. Cabaret music, please. Some of you may know, I am a soccer referee, and I have been for 30 years. United States Soccer Federation College Referee. 30 years, 2,000 games. I've refereed kids, adults, boys, girls, amateurs, professionals. Started from the bottom, now I'm here. I've had the opportunity to do the U.S. men's national team. Claim of fame was I was the fourth official on Orlando City's first game, preseason versus Philadelphia Union 5 years ago. And over 30 years and 2,000 games, there's no better way to talk about sticks and stones. Over 30 years and 2,000 games, not only have I seen it all, but I've heard it all also. Let us go over a few examples together. Crystal.
You suck, ref.
With feeling.
You suck, ref.
Come on, everybody.
Here it is.
College soccer player to a 40-year-old husband who just wants to get away from his wife on the weekend. To a 7-year-old boy who's just learning the beauty of giving it to the ref. So simple, so sweet, right? The best way to communicate what they want to say to the referee. How about this one? Rich.
Meet me in the parking lot after the game, ref.
Really? What are we going to do? Have some tea?
We're going to have a talk.
We're going to have a little talk? Really? Fortunately, I've never had to actually meet anybody in the parking lot. Although a few of my friends have. And so not only do we get threats directed at us, but we can be physically threatened as well. That's why it's always good to have some security or maybe police officers or two after the game. Or maybe some big referees are standing right next to you. James. Come on, James.
The referee, a wanker.
Say with feeling, James.
Referee's a wanker.
There we go. Get your British on. Get your British on, James. One more time.
The referee's a wanker.
The referee's a wanker. That's right. Anybody heard this one before?
No.
No. Look it up. Go to England. Go to Great Britain. Yeah, there's tons of British, and apparently it's transformed itself into American slang. Right? It's great. One of my personal favorites. We get directed tons of abuse. But here's one of my all-time crowd favorites, Stephanie.
I hope there's no profanity in this. Can
you give it to Julia?
I'm blind. I'm deaf. I wanna be a ref.
Everybody, one more time. Everybody, one more time. I feel like
I'm blind. I'm deaf. I wanna be a ref.
I think I've seen a few of you in the supporters section at Orlando City. Yes, Carmen's been yelling that one out for the last 3 years, right? Justo, with passion. But there are some things us referees do take personal. Some things we can't get over. It's those personal hit shots. And And this, I still haven't gotten over this. Yes, Amy. Ooh, this is gonna hurt.
Rev, your forehead is so big you can land a plane on it.
I'm at Louisiana State University last year, and out of nowhere, this frat boy in front of all his students hurls that one at you. Almost had to stop the game. Not because I was pissed, because it was so damn funny. Now everybody laughing. The kids could barely kick the ball. I'm at Disney Springs this weekend, and I'm telling this story to a friend of mine, and his 9-year-old son's apparently here overhearing the conversation. His 9-year-old son goes, "Dad, people really land a plane on his forehead." But there is a lesson in all this, folks. No better way to talk about sticks and stones. Right? We can't take things personal. Especially in this environment. We should take the time to understand sticks and stones. And there's an especially important part of the population that needs to understand this better. What do you call those people that think they know everything? That want everything given to them, handed to them on a silver platter.
Millennials.
Right. Thank you very much. Where are these goddamn millennials? Where are the parents? Have they never been taught in the immortal world words of that philosopher and poet and stateswoman, Taylor Swift? Yes. Shake it off. Our children need to understand that they do suck. They're the worst thing that ever happened to them. Or in a nicer way, as Grandma would say, sticks and stones may break my bones, but
words never hurt me.
Thank
where he can't take me out of. I am very blessed to have what I have in my life, and I wouldn't have it any other way. And I can't wait to see what God has in store for me. Thank you. Well.
shit about an event in your life. What do you find yourself doing and why? Shame.
Dang. Can you repeat the question?
You heard me.
No, I didn't.
If you didn't give a shit about an event in your life, what do you find yourself doing and why?
Yeah. You're referring to when I don't give a shit about an event. Oh, I see. If I don't give a shit about an event in my life, I'm buying myself some time here. And why? First of all, I just want to state that I'm not a member, so I'm not under any obligation to actually answer.
You've been a guest for a long time.
Generally, I find myself just responding recently anyways with politeness and courteousness. I've found that it helps cultivate potentially a future relationship with this person that may benefit my professional career or personal life in some way. If I really don't give a shit, I'll let them know.
When you find yourself not able to fall asleep at night, what do you do to find bliss and not drift off to a sweet slumber in Tara?
I find happiness by being able to fall asleep, and I don't have any problem with it at all. My husband actually does most of the driving when we go around, and we call me the Napigator. So my happiness is that I can fall asleep, but sometimes it's not so appropriate. I can't drive for more than half an hour without feeling very sleepy. I had to pull over today. But I allow for that time. I allow for it. And I'm trying.
What?
And it's crazy. It's the truth. So I'm happy when I'm sleeping an appropriate time, and that's at night.
Finally. What drugs have you tried in your life, and what was your experience?
Tabletop Mixmaster, what are those things? I'm afraid you'll have to describe them to me. I'm sure you know them far better than I do. Alas, it's the way I've been. I haven't had any real interest in such because my stimulation comes from being aware of my situation. I'm more intellectually stimulated rather than chemically stimulated. So these table topic questions can be very entertaining, not always successful, but it gets the juices flowing. What I would have to say then is that of those that I've tried to think about them once in a while, but I would have a whole lot more fun building something, creating something, rather than just be sitting there stewing in some other induced state. In which case, I'll just use hypnosis at that point, so.
Have you ever been threatened or insulted by someone you're trying to help? Gus. Ooh.
Fellow Toastmaster, have I ever been insulted? Yes, I have. I was at a hospital, I will not name the hospital, I was trying to work as a chaplain, and this guy invited me into, they called me on the pager that said, go to this room, so I walked in and the guy said, he said some words I don't want to repeat, but it was literally, I needed to get out of the room. So in that professional setting, you pause, you listen, and you waited. Then he used more profanity because I was standing and I couldn't, but I knew he was on some chemical substance that was causing him to react that way. And so I stood again and I just had an eye contact and I looked at him, then it said, get out, then I did. So that was one of my
find yourself dreaming at night. What do you find yourself dreaming about that you remember when you wake up, Mr. Orr?
I don't really sleep that much anyways. But I do find that when I do dream, and this is why I cannot read books about business or anything like that before I go to bed, is because I will drive myself crazy all night thinking about everything that I just read, trying to solve the world's problems, trying to remember some random math equation from that I should have already known from eighth grade algebra, but all of a sudden it's just one of those things you forget, and you wake up and then you search your phone and then you start Googling, and then that just turns into one Google after another Google after another Google, and before you know it, you've spent the last 3 hours reteaching yourself things that you probably should have already known, but somehow I've forgotten because it's 2 o'clock in the morning, you're not thinking correctly anyway. And then it's time to wake up and start your real day. So those are usually the things when I dream about something, it usually has to do with something I did right before I went to bed, and that really wrecks the whole rest of the night. So watch what you do before you go to bed, because it could really determine your next 48 hours.
Well done.
This is the educational portion of the meeting. We're trying to make sense of what we went through already earlier today. This is a little atypical of a meeting this morning. I think Stephen's going to have to be a little busy with the censor button on this before this meeting gets posted online. I swear there's usually not this much profanity. So this is where we go through and learn about areas we can improve on, get constructive feedback on the speeches that we've heard today. So first up, I want to introduce our first evaluator, Stacey Burbanek, who's going to be evaluating Nini's icebreaker speech this morning.
Yay, Stacey! What I found is that I see where you're heading, and I see the determination that you have, which is great. One of the things I would say is to be sure to use your full time. I know what's helped me in the past is timing myself, and then if I notice that I'm a little low on time, I will add some more, because we want to hear as much about you as possible. And then another thing I noticed is look up from your notes. But other than that, you did really well. Your voice is very strong, and you did really well today. So congratulations.
Evaluating our second speaker this morning is going to be Rich Massa evaluating Julia Kaufman's speech.
Easy goes, Rich. Easy goes.
Thank you, Mr. Evaluator, fellow members and guests, and especially Julia. I don't want to spend too much time up here because a stitch in time saves nine. And I feel very blithe today, especially for Mark's legs. So you notice one of the definitions is feeling gay. Great legs. No homo, Martin. Julia, I love this speech, mainly because you said the word shit. I think we used so much inappropriate language today, the Stephen's video is going to sound like the emergency broadcasting on the video. What a great topic, using the meanings behind words of phrases that we don't use every day. I felt it was, you used great vernacular, you used personal stories, you wrapped it up. Great body language, I love the cool beans when you're like, hey man, that was great. I love it. You used amazing eye contact. You connected with the audience. The one area I would feel that you could use work on is, I noticed that you slapped your thighs a lot, and it was a little bit distracting. And also, if the flag drops, it's okay. You're not un-American if you let it sit on the floor.
You are.
So, other than that, I loved how you brought the audience attention in with the common phrases. You made us laugh. You captured our attention. I don't know how, with such an amazing speaker like you, any type of criticism I can give you. So, I applaud the speech today. Give her a big round of applause.
That bother me when people say, circle back.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Circle back, you're like, please don't. Next up, evaluating. Actually, before. I just want to share one thing about referees, and I know Mark left out here. In the Orlando City games, I know this is a very frequent chant to the referees that they like to chant, and it says, the ref belongs on OBT. For those of you who are new here, OBT is a road frequented by women of the night. Next up, evaluating Martin's speech on Sticks and Stones, James Harris.
Yay.
Sticks and stones may break my bones, but names will never hurt me. Martin Bell, insane speaker, number 3. Very good. 2 questions. What indicated the audience was entertained? Laughter, smiles, comments to each other. You had the attention 100%. I was entertained. Very good. Organization. Get a clear opening, dress very appropriate, you look like a coach. And I think you took off your outfit, even like a player. Very good. How effectively did the speaker use vivid descriptions and stories? You involved the audience, or its participant, that was very good. That's a very good technique. How did the conclusion relate? It was very appropriate. It fell right in line. You had your audience to complete that you had. The shows that were listening. Sticks and stones do what? Yeah, still there. How could the speaker improve? Opening body conclusion. The opening was so developing. I think you should have used your conclusion as your opening. Sticks and stones, babe. What? You didn't go right into your audience, right into your speech. The body, very many good examples, was very good. Supported your entire subject. And the conclusion, square, right line. Appreciate your good work. Thanks. Yep.
I'll just make some quick general comments about the broad meeting. Actually, I'm not going to make some quick comments. I'm going to go to the technical table first, and then I'm going to make comments. So, first up, we have our technical table here who's going to give us feedback in different areas that they explained before the meeting started. So we'll start out first with our timer. Julia Buckley.
Good morning, fellow Toastmasters and gentlemen. Our times were excellent this morning. Excellent. Nina, 3:01 in your icebreaker. Congratulations. And Julia Kaufman took 6:37. And Martin Bell was 7:30. The table topic speakers, of which there were many, thank you very much, Michael. Macarena took 35 seconds. Shane, 48 seconds. Tara, 42 seconds. Stephen, 1 minute. Gus, 51 seconds. and Jorge 1 minute and 6 seconds. And our evaluators again, excellent timing. Stacy, 59 seconds. Rich, 1 minute 43. And James, 1 minute 48. Thank you.
Next up, we're going to get our odd counter report from Carmen Lopez.
Yeah.
Two leg in-os and 4 double clutches. Nini, was your icebreaker, you were nervous. You did have about 16 ums. You had 1 in-o and then 1 double clutch. I did like how you said my first leg, second leg, third leg.
Yes. Yeah.
Julia, you had 1 well, 3 so's and 1 double clutch. Martin Bell, Julia Kaufmaner. Martin Bell, the 1 ah, 1 butt, 1 like-you-know, and 2 double clutches. Mike, you were clean.
Oh,
okay. Warrior. Table topics, you had 1 um and 1 but. General evaluation, you had 1 double clutch. Stacy had 2 ums. Rich had 1 um and 5 double clutches. James had 1 double clutch. Macarena was clean. Shane, the guest, had 2 ums and 1 double clutch.
I was by touch.
Yes. Tara had 1 butt. Steven had 1 so. Gus had 1 so. Thunderbird.
Next up, we'll have the grammarian report from Crystal Strickland.
Only 4 uses of the word blithe. Oh, very unfair. That makes me feel not so blithe. Some of the most colorful phrases that I really enjoyed today were a diamond in the works,
yes,
and a sponge for knowledge. Good job. Does that make me shitless? And get me off this idiom. Roller coaster is another phrase that's going to stick with me all day. Let's see, Martin started from the bottom down here. And I'm blind, I'm deaf, I want to be a rep, I loved it. And Rich, no homo. And that's my report, thank you.
About the meeting. It did start on time. I like to have a full house here. I just want to remind people I was a little late. I know there were a couple other people a little late. Just wait until there's breaks in the speaking before we come in and out of the rooms. The room was set up appropriately. I like this new format here that we're doing. I know every week I come, I feel like there's something a little bit different, but I like the way that everything's set up. The flag wasn't cooperating too much today, but I think I just wanted some love and attention today.
I put it there.
So at this time, I'm going to ask Julia Kaufman to come up and address our club business.
All right. So, award that you can get as a Toastmaster, in my opinion, my humble opinion, that's the icebreaker ribbon. I am so proud to be able to give this to me.
Yes.
Congratulations. That earned us 10 out of 10, baby, on April 10th. We are now a Distinguished President's Club this year, thanks to Alexandra, who earned her Advanced Communicator Silver Pin. So if she was here, she would get this pin. So congratulations, everyone, because you guys are what made us President's Distinguished as of April 10th. Unheard of. Way to go! the mood and true, and hear the best stories. Like Mimi's story blew me away this morning.
Yes.
All right, we have great amount of guests today, and I'd like to hear from you on what you thought of today's meeting. And I'm going to start with a current Toastmaster from a different club. Marvin, what did you think of our meeting today? Yes.
Yeah. Always blithe. It's very enjoyable. I want to continue to come, and I'm going to inquire about being a member.
Here it is. Yes.
Well, jump in anytime, and just keep coming back. So welcome here. I know your mom is here, but I don't know your name.
Oh.
So what do you think of today's meeting?
Oh, that's your mom.
Okay. Yes.
Wow.
It's my first time here, but I like him. I like everything. Que support, like she say, everybody say how is your yes, the speech correctly or no? I like it. I like it.
Hello, my name is Alexandra Quintero, and I'm Mimi's little sister. I did go to the Toastmasters in Semel State, but I'm going. But when I go back, I'm going to start doing it again. I haven't done my icebreaker over there, but I tend to do it probably this summer or next semester, hopefully. Keep going on it. I like it. There's more amusing here. There's more laughter over there. There's only like two students, and the rest are faculty, but it's cool.
Bring your students, bring your friends.
All right, I will. Thank you very much.
Wow.
First of all, I don't know what blithe means, but I assume we still get credit just for using it. I enjoyed the meeting. I enjoyed the speeches today. Great job on the icebreaker.
Yes.
That you got deep, and we really got to know you. So congratulations to you. You've overcome a lot of things. I've been trying to sign up for weeks, but this guy won't send me. I'm going to force money down his throat.
I'll take it.
So.
All right. Welcome.
Welcome.
Oh. It's a great coffee. You're talking about the coffee or the meeting? The meeting is a cool beans anyway. The energy is powerful. I think it's inspiring. A lot of speakers done their best. And I think this is one of the clubs that actually have a teamwork. That I've been to a lot of clubs, but I see a lot of full attendance in here. Somehow the club fall off, but I really wanted to join the club. However, you didn't send me the information. Oh, oh,
oh, you're fired.
Now I know why you sent you.
You're matched between our VP of Education and our VP membership. So before you leave,
yeah, we're gonna get there.
This is my third time putting my email. Thank you so much.
Hey, I have it right here.
Oh, you got my name right here. Right?
Yes. Thank you. Right. We'll have you join.
Love it. All right, we have our agenda for next week, and the schedule is. All right, here we go. Keep longer arms. Toastmaster, James. Toastmaster, Jeff.
Yes.
Tara.
Oh, it's a female.
Speaking. Hey. Dexter, your
icebreaker.
Yeah.
Oh, we got an icebreaker next week. Stacy, you're speaking. Jorge, you're speaking. All right. We have Alexander. We'll have to check with Carrie's, our general evaluator. I'm evaluating. We have to check with Marty and Lori. You're scheduled to be an evaluator.
Oh,
good. And Nene, you're going to be an on-counter. And Samuel, Slacker Sam.
Slacker Samuel.
Okay, sleeping in. Carmen, he's supposed to be grammarian. All right. All right. Any business? VP of Education, News. Stephen, VP PR.
Drugs.
The Division D contest is this coming Sunday, and we will have Phyllis representing us as the area representative for Division for Area 45 in the Division D contest. So if you can get out to that, that's going to be at Mayflower Retirement Community this coming Sunday. I'll have to get the time straight to send it out.
3 to 6.
All right. So please, if you have that time available, come out. It's always interesting to see because you're also going to be seeing the international speech contest, the winners of the areas, and who will be going on to the district at the next level.
They're powerful.
Please do.
Yeah. Thanks, Stephen. I had forgotten. All right. Gus, any news? Ed.
Yeah, Gus.
I'm going to have two members join, and I'm working on sister here. Tara, you've already joined, and you're giving your icebreaker.
No, next week, sir.
Next week. Who is your mentor?
Miss Lori.
Okay, you have a good one. Thank you, Stephanie, for setting that up.
Yeah.
Just to encourage you to come in with your manuals, you bring in your competent leader. I'm doing the one for Julia today so that you can get credit for the functions you do. But we are very encouraged by those who are moving along with their speeches. I think we're going to have a competent communicator shortly that will complete your 10 speeches. Right, Lori? Mm-hmm. How many more you have to do?
Just the 10.
Yeah, the 10. Okay. So we're looking forward to that. We're doing very well. And then the timing, the general evaluator talked about that. Let's just be able to make it on the timing. Anyone having a challenge with Easy Speak?
With what?
Easy Speak for signing.
Oh, I was having a hard time.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
All right, let's
like help with that.
Let's talk about that to sign in for.
Is it supposed to be the same login for Toastmasters as
no.
well?
No.
So
I tried signing up and then it said my email address was already signed up.
All right.
Yes, because Gus would have entered you in.
Yeah, she already
so
in there.
You need to send her your user ID. And
user ID, that's
right.
She
sent the password.
Right, I'll work on that, yeah. You know what, like how I get it? This is the best place to grow as a leader. This is the best place to grow as a leader.
You're human.
Yeah, you get good criticism that helps you grow. So I thank you very much for that.
Giving a seminar. It starts at 6:30 at my office. If anybody can come, that would be great.
Thank you.
Right. Yes.
Free massages. Free massages.
How long is it? About an hour.
Oh, wow.
Where is your office?
Are you doing a speech?
Mm-hmm.
So you
need
an
evaluator
in
there.
So
Gotta
get credit every speech, man.
Yes.
Wow. No free
speeches.
We can do that.
No free speeches. With that, meeting of